everybody. As a professional, we belong to teaching community, and as a school head and teacher, you must be facing number of issues related to school infrastructure, student behavior, teacher absenteeism in your everyday school life. You can share your problems with members of your peer group. For this, you need to create space, time, and opportunity to share your experiences. In this session, friends, we are going to discuss how you can create such communities of schools and how it can be used as a forum to learn from others' experiences. What do we mean by the term community of schools? The term community of schools describes a collegial group of school heads and teachers who are united to their commitment to school improvement and student learning. It is a way of working together, sharing ideas, and supporting one another to update knowledge and skills. A community of schools engages the entire group of professionals in coming together for learning. The basic concept is clarified by a video in which the group of school heads either identifies a problem and discusses with other professionals for problem solving, or debate on an issue, or share the knowledge with one another. They will also discuss on the effective ways to handle challenges and overcome problems in their roles as a school head or as a school teacher. Now let us understand this concept with the help of a role play documented as a video. Thank you.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hello.
Thanks for accepting this invitation and coming here, giving us a new platform to discuss our issues and concerns. Like last time, we had also met, and it was a very fruitful meeting. We had discussed so many things related to our schools. And as far as I remember, Mr. Santosh had raised an issue of indiscipline in the schools in general. So due to lack of time at that day, we were not able to conclude it.
Yeah.
So why not start the discussion with the problem of indiscipline only?
Yes, I agree, Lina ma'am. What I feel is that the modern school system faces gross indiscipline, decline in the social value system, moral standards, violent and aggressive behavior, late coming uniforms, and exclusive addiction to the gadgets, etc., truancy, and irregularity, which is coming up in the modern times. So this is the issue which I would like to highlight as a major issue these days.
Although the problem of discipline in my present school is not a big problem, rather I would say that the level of discipline are quite satisfactory. But in a previous school where I was posted earlier, there were a group of students who were in the habit of substance abuse. They used to put that fluid which is used for fixing punctures, they would put it on their hankies and would continue to inhale while the teacher is teaching in the class. And teacher also would think that perhaps they are suffering from cold or something. So the problem could not be noticed for quite some time. And the other students were also afraid of those students, so they did not inform the teacher. So over a period of time, some more students started falling prey to the problem. And finally, it so happened that some students got to a point where they started sipping that solution. And
did they counsel?
That's the point when it was noticed by the teachers and all the staff. So a team was formed to counter that problem.
Mm-hmm.
So each and every room of the school used to be made surprise visits by those teachers, even twice, thrice a day. Those students were counseled, their parents were contacted, called and counseled by HOS, by the staff of the school. Every room of the school which was not in use was decided to be locked. And over a period of time that problem could be.
You are right, Mr. Harish. Parental involvement is very important here. I think, you know, even being irregular to school is a part of being indisciplined. And only a joint action by the school, teachers and the parents will offer a sustainable solution to the problem. As a HOS, The school head can ensure, of course, teaching is made very interesting and full of fun. When there is joyful learning, children would love to come to school. The school and learning will become very important to them, and they will not miss the school at all.
Yes, I agree, Rajshree ma'am, that if teachers do not engage the children properly in their classrooms, then there is no connectivity between the teachers and the students.
Yes.
And the children will definitely try an escape route, which leads to truancy. In my school, a culture has been created where the truancy is nil. Every child leaves the school only with the parents with the prior permission of their choice. Even though there is a market very near to the school, but they don't leave the school during the school hours.
So really some very good points have come up and which can really help us to reduce indiscipline in our schools respectively, like engagement of students as told by Mr. Santosh, and proper vigilance, proper counseling by teachers, HOS and parents, as Mr. Harish said, and joyful learning is the best way, like Mrs. Rajshree told us. Nice conclusion.
Yeah. And, you know, there is a lot that we can share also in this platform. Like, you know, one the reflective practices and team building and all that. Mr. Santosh, you used to tell us about the things that you wanted to share in knowledge.
Yes, absolutely, ma'am. Because since we have identified that discipline is a core issue, I believe that in the school, discipline is a collective effort between the teachers, students and the principal and the entire staff, teaching and non-teaching staff. So seen in a totality, the teacher discipline, HOS discipline, student discipline, all creates a discipline culture in the school.
Yes.
I enable this, that the teaching community to nip at the bud, even if the discipline issue is pretty small. So we will try to identify the problem even before it became a very big serious issue.
It is rightly mentioned that discipline concerns all.
Yes.
I think for this, a team effort is required in a school. And not only for discipline, but for every other activity, team efforts are more important rather than group dynamics.
Yes.
In a team, every member is made accountable. No teacher of the school should be left alone. He should become member of one or more team. Rather, he should be made member of one or more teams. So that he understands his responsibility, he understands his role, he feels involved in the situation, he understands the practicability and in implementing the solutions, and at the same time he doesn't become a fence sitter where he just observes other working in the school and just starts to criticize.
Yes, I think, you know, for this individual reflection is needed. I had the opportunity of learning a lot about team building and the reflection from the discussions and the course content of the PG Diploma in School Leadership and Management at NUPA. As a HOS, I have found it very useful to lead from behind and let the team totally get involved in the development of the school. These were taught to us at NUPA. And, you know, the school, its discipline, all these are very important besides the academics. Sometimes, without even they are realizing it, I keep my teachers and enable them to give feedback or write a note, short note, where, you know, it is very essential that they reflect and then write that note. You know, this is a practice that I have started following after this, my NUPA days. They reflect these days, they reflect and then give those feedbacks.
I agree with Mrs. Rajshree. Reflections really give us a strong understanding of ourselves and our surroundings also. Like many a times when we are in our schools and dealing with problems or situations, we cannot see it in totality. After all, we are also impulsive and our decisions cannot be so perfect all the time. And while they are having a great impact on the students and the school, this I have found it very helpful. When I give those situations an afterthought in the form of reflections, I can fully assure it really helps a lot. Like a few days ago, a teacher came to me with an issue and was in a bad state of mind. I caught up with her vibes and lost my temper too. Finally, when she had gone, I felt bad about her and my behavior. Further, I took some time for reflection and rehearsed in my mind how the situation should have been handled. How should I have reacted at that time? And immediately it came to my mind that this was the point where I had gone wrong. I called the teacher again and we had a nice conversation and she left the office in a smiling mood. So this is what even a team needs. When we want to build a team, we first have to know ourselves, our surroundings, and reflection is the best way to attain it. To know ourselves, to know the people who we are working with. Reflection is the best way, I suppose.
Yeah.
Now as a good practices are being shared, though it's not in the same context,
okay.
But there is a practice in our government schools of adopting the students who need extra academic care. So generally what happens that the students are adopted by the teachers who take regular periods in those classes.
Mm-hmm.
Now last year we deviated from this practice. What we did is that the students were adopted by the teachers who do not have a regular period in those classes. So the idea behind this was that generally there is a trend that a teacher who adopts from the same regular classes,
mm-hmm.
over a period of time he tends to neglect those students. Whereas if another teacher adopts those students who is not having a regular period in that class, he would specially go to those students, and the teacher who is taking regular period would take extra care. He would be aware that another teacher is going to have a look at his notebooks and other activities. So he also becomes vigilant about those students. And in this way, we feel that even the professional growth of the teachers also took place. We found it useful last year.
Yeah, that is true. You know, though I am HOS, I have not left teaching at all.
Yeah.
I do take a few classes in my subject. And this time around, you know, it was improving the writing skills of my students. And over an interaction, you know, I just found out that students could acknowledge the dismal state of affairs of their writing skills. And I was able to elicit from them as to where they needed that improvement. And the brainstorming session helped us in pinpointing to the problems, their background. And the topic given was very, very, you know, trendy, I should say, very, very relevant to the present situation. Is Swachhta Abhiyan a reality? Then students felt themselves that they have to connect with the problem in order to effectively find a solution. And over this discussion, you know, they found that they were able to form a big word bank, and this solved the vocabulary problem. Then, you know, they said, ma'am, you had shown us the video of video clipping of a good school, very clean school. We would do one thing, we would take the pictures of the dirty areas of our school and then show it to our children and appeal to them. I said, go ahead.
Wonderful.
And then make use of my mobile phone. You cannot bring it to school, I said. Then they did. They enjoyed the freedom. The school started improving in its cleanliness. And, you know, they went ahead a step further. What they did, they took videos of their own colony, wherever they found something in need of improvement. And then they wrote one letter, got it corrected by me, and then they sent that letter to the municipal commissioner along with the CD. You won't imagine there is such a quick action for the letter by the students. They came and then they asked, please show us where we need to contribute to the cleanliness of the school as well as the colony. You know, so I felt very proud, you know, for this act by the students and my having to facilitate this kind of an exercise in my school.
That's great.
It was wonderful feeling.
That's great.
Academic reform turned into social reform.
Yeah.
I gave importance to in my school to school infrastructure when I took over as HOS. And I took initiative in doing effective counseling of the students, because that is a very important pathway for maintaining discipline wherever needed. And provision of resources also I did, and created a proper communication channel with all the students and the teachers. And I insisted on the training of new methodology or new methods of teaching learning process in the school.
Yes,
which
sir.
Gave us good result, and it
mm-hmm.
is ensuring that we are getting 100% results in the CBSE
mm-hmm.
examination.
Okay, that's good.
So even we have started a practice of zero period in our school, in which teacher informally talks to the children, to the students, and in general she tries to know about their family, their background, their friends, etc. And if she thinks that there is an issue on which she can work upon, she really tries to do that. And not only the students are telling about their family, the teacher is also telling about her problems, her family issues, her children. So the teacher and the students are getting to know more about each other, and they are coming closer also. And in general, like any burning topic, which is in the contemporary context, they try to discuss that also. So in a way, it is helping them to build up a relationship amongst each other.
Yes.
So this is also a good thing.
Thank you, Lina ma'am, for providing us with this opportunity and platform where we could discuss our problems, and by sharing knowledge and best practices, right now we feel more enlightened. I would also request that such meetings should be held at regular intervals so that we can script a path to better educational administration.
Definitely, sir. I'm very grateful to everybody for coming here. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Friends, you have seen in the video as to how the school heads of four different schools met together and shared their problems of student discipline. They also shared their best practices of teaching learning and giving special attention to those children who needs extra academic support. They also emphasized on introducing the practice of self-reflection in your school. I hope you can make a group with other school heads in your neighborhood and share the best practices and learn from each other's experiences. You can also interact through the social media like Google Group, Facebook, even if you are not able to meet face to face. I hope that you will create space and you will also have some time to share your experiences with other peer group members. Thank you.